I mean, just high, you know what I mean? I'm just gonna put some music on right now. I hope you guys enjoy the show. That's all I gotta say. I don't know what I'm gonna say, but I'm gonna say something. All right? You bet your bottom dollar and your euros too. You know what I mean? You know what? It's like in this life, we all are dealing. Now look at the hole in my long johns, please. We have to somehow. We have to deal. We have to deal with the inconsistencies and the struggles that this life does bring. We will argue. We will laugh. We will cry. We will sing. And yet, sometimes we will act like a crazy ding-a-ling. But that's all right. It's alright. Everyone's always trying to figure out the ultimate equation. But really? Is there really an ultimate equation? We will play. We will be serious. We will do all the things we all do. We will entertain our ideas, our notions, our concepts. But if you lose the child, then where are you? You ever wondered how a child, unless you're not totally bitter, child will bring joy out of you? And why is that? We're all children in the face of eternal infinity. And maybe you need to, like, be reborn 100,000 times to realize that. I understand. When you die, you leave this encasement, end up in another one. And then when you're reborn somewhere else, some people are just reborn right away, but that's rare. You will go through a bardo, a period of limbo, and then you'll end up in another realm for the most part. And then you'll recollect on things that you did and wayward ways in which you thought, assuming that life is just what you thought it was. But then, eventually, the force of your own desires drags you back, if you will, into another embodiment. In which case, you will enter another womb. And then be reborn, for the most part, forgetting everything of not only your previous life, but also the plane that you just came from. So what to do? Ah, well, so many theories abound as to how to make sense of all this. But we have our will, don't we? Right? We have our will. But in the face of adversity, in the face of so many conflicting wills besides our own, it's not so easy to exercise that will, now is it? Of course it isn't. We are taught to fear death. And yet, death is not what brings pain. Death is the release of time itself. Death is change itself. Death is never, and can never, and has never been an end to anything. But it takes a lot to realize that the soul is indestructible. And so you can read, 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 you can read. I know, I've read like too much. I've meditated too much. And this is why I am now the happy-go-lucky dunce I am. If I didn't feel that I would lose my account on YouTube and Facebook right now, I would scratch my balls, because I have a mad itch on my balls, and it happens, guys. We all scratch our balls. We all do. You know what I mean? But I guess I'm just gonna have to exert mind over matter and wait till this video is over in order to scratch my happy nutsack. Listen, you know what? People think that I'm not serious when I engage in humor. But I think that gravity is overrated, just like too much levity is overrated. Right now, I just wanted to share a song. Let me see if this is the one. Life, I need my love to be here. Making each day of the year. Everywhere, and if she's beside me, I need never care. But to love her is to need her everywhere. Knowing that love is to share. Everywhere, and she's beside me, I know I would never care, but to love her is to meet her everywhere, knowing that love is to share, each one believing how good love never dies, in your eyes. I'm always there, there, and everywhere, here, there, and everywhere. Thank you. I'm done.